I met Gary Pate at the missionary dinner, and then COVID hit. So that kind of planted the seed to go to Ecuador.
Well, we started out at the headquarters, packing up 600 backpacks full of rulers and pencils and pens and scissors and erasers. That was quite the project. And then we'd load up into Gary and Dina's vans and head off to a different town for our Bible class. And the most interesting one to me was the most remote one that we drove deep into jungle roads. And at one point there was no road and a bulldozer had to make a road for us to get there. And in the most remote villages that were the poorest, the people were so warm and generous, and they made fresh cornbread on the inside of a burning wood fire. They left us with bags of vegetables.
Even though they have, and I say little to nothing, they have each other. You would see the families in the villages with the outdoor cooking areas, with small gardens going here and there, with their livestock all around, running free, whether it be the pigs, the chickens, whatever it might be. As a group, as a village, they all worked together to raise their families. And they were all happy. With the many kids there, as Gary mentioned, that if one just understands and takes the information and spreads it to the others, then it grows and grows and grows, and Jesus' name is spread throughout.
To go to a land that is way less affluent and the people live much simpler lives, and to experience the joy that they have even in their struggles was inspirational to me. And also, Gary and Dina and the team that work for them, the missionaries, their young people, were so inspired and touched by God that they were a wonderful role model for me. So that week, I take back the love with they did all their work.
When we first thought about it, I figured you do like VBS, Children's Bible School, something like that. They're doing this twice a day, 4 days a week, 8 times. The Pate ministry is just expanding. It's gone from the mountains to the coast, and they're doing with the kids and the adults and the women, and there's all kinds of things, so they want to do even more. They're giving out Bibles, and the Bibles are like $5 a piece. They're putting the backpacks together. They're giving out school supplies, and these kids literally don't have much of anything. So they're kind of going over and above what you would think a missionary would do.